Hello and warm welcome to all of you in the third part of the chapter, the French Revolution. Dear student, yesterday we discussed the causes of the French Revolution. I explained you that when Louis XVI came into power, the treasury of the France was totally empty. So he decided to increase further taxes. Because of this, the people of France started to oppose it, and they also started protest against the system. Today we are going to discuss the outbreak of the revolution. Louis XVI had to increase taxes for reason you have learned in the previous section. How do you think he could have gone about doing this? In France of the old regime, the monarch did not have the power to impose taxes according to his will alone. Yesterday we discussed that because of the political, social, economical reason, he decided to increase further taxes. But in the old regime, now what do we mean by this old regime? I already explained in the second lecture of this chapter. Old regime means the institution of the France before 1789. So in the old regime, France king had no power to increase taxes or impose taxes alone. He had to consult with the representative of the estate general. Rather, he had to call a meeting of estate general, which would then pass his proposal for new taxes. He was not only responsible to impose taxes or increase taxes, but he had to call the meeting of estate general. Now here the question is, what is this estate general? The estate general was a political body to which the three estates sent their representative. This is very important, student. Might in the exam this kind of question can come. What do you mean by estate general? So estate general is a political body of representative of three estate. First estate, clergy; second estate, nobility; and the third estate, common people. However, the monarch alone could decide when to call a meeting of this body. The last time it was done was in 1614. Yeah, the king had power to call the meeting. He can decide. He could decide when he had to call a meeting. Last time, this time of assembly was called in the year 1640. On 5th May 1789, Louis XVI called together an assembly of the estate general to pass proposal for new taxes. A resplendent hall in Versailles was prepared to host the delegate. So he decided to call a meeting on 5th May 1789. He decided to call the meeting of assembly, meeting of representative from all three estates on 5th May 1789 to pass his proposal to increase taxes. This meeting was held at the beautiful hall, gorgeous hall at Versailles. The first and second estate sent 300 representatives each, who were seated in rows facing each other on two sides. First two estates, first estate and second estate, each these two estates, they sent their 300 representatives from each estate. And they all were sitting in this ring. So these people, first and second estates and their 300 representatives each, who were seated in rows facing each other. They were sitting in this direction and they were facing each other. But the 600 members of the third estate had to stand at the back. But the 600 representatives from third estate, they have to stand at the back of these two estate people. They were not allowed to sit. The third estate was represented by its more prosperous and educated member. Now, who were the member of the third estate? In the third estate, as we discussed, businessman, administrative official, lawyer, other official were there, other professional were there, peasants were there, landless labor were there, worker was there. But all these people were not allowed to represent third estate. But from the third estate, educated people and prosperous people of the third estate, they represented the third estate. Peasants, artisans and women were denied entry to the assembly. Peasant, artisan and women, they were not allowed. So here 300 representatives from the first estate, from 300 from the second estate and 600 representatives from the third estate, they all presented in the hall at Versailles on 5th May 1789. However, their grievances and demands were listed in some 40,000 letters which the representative had brought with them. Peasants, women and other less prosperous people, they were not allowed to represent third estate, but they had written their grievances to the representative of the third estate. Voting in the estate general in the past had been conducted according to the principle that each estate had one vote. This time to Louis XVI was determined to continue the same practice. Now, voting of the estate general in the past, it was conducted in a such manner each state had right to give one vote for the whole estate. And this time also Louis XVI, he want to continue the same pattern. But member of the third estate demanded the voting now be conducted by assembly as a whole, where each member would have one vote. But third estate member were not agree with the past pattern. They demanded each member of all the state, they were allowed to give one vote. Means they demanded per member, one vote. This was one of the democratic principles put forward by philosopher like Rousseau in his book The Social Contract. Yesterday we discussed about that the philosopher, he had written the book Social Contract, and in his book he described equality for all people. When the king rejected this proposal, members of the third estate walked out of the assembly in protest. They demanded of voting for per member, one vote, one person. But king rejected their proposal, so in protest, they all, means all the members of the estate general, they walk out of the assembly. The representative of the third estate viewed themselves as spokesperson for the whole French nation. They left the assembly and they all opposed the decision of the king. On 20 June, they assembled in the hall of an indoor tennis court in the ground of Versailles. They declared themselves a national assembly and swore not to disperse till they had drafted a constitution for France that would limit the power of the monarch. On 20 of June, all the representatives of the third estate, they assemble in a one underground tennis court hall at worship, and they all had taken a oath. They all will not disperse till they drafted the constitution which put limit on the power of the monarch. Means they decided to write down a new constitution, and this constitution put limit on the power of the monarch. All the members of the third estate, means all the representative, they declared themselves as a national assembly. They were led by Mirabeau and Abesagius, two main leader. They provide the leadership to these people. One person is Mirabeau and the second one is Abesagius. Mirabeau was born in a noble family but was convinced of the need to do away with the society of feudal privileges. Mirabeau, he was a noble, but he not believe in the discrimination. He was not agree with the privileges they are getting by the court. He brought out a journal and delivered powerful speeches to the crowd assembled at worship. He wrote his idea in one journal and he criticized the division of French society. Abesagius, originally he was a priest, wrote an influential pamphlet called What is the Third Estate. Abesagius, he was a priest in the church, means he was from the church. He belonged to church people, but he was also not agree with the social division of the France. So he decided to support these third estate people. While the National Assembly was busy at Versailles drafting the constitution, the rest of the France seethed with turmoil. A severe winter had meant a bad harvest. The price of the bread rose. Often baker exploited the situation and hoarded supplies. This National Assembly, they were busy in the for the drafting of new constitution for the France. At the same time, whole France was living in confusion. This was also accompanied by bad harvest. Due to the bad harvest, the food production decreased. So the bakers took the advantage of this situation, and again the prices of the prices of the food increasing very high. After spending hour in a long queue at a bakery, crowd of angry women stormed into the shop. In those days, there was a shortage of food grain, so people who want to purchase the food, they had to stand in a queue for a long time. So many women, they were standing in a queue for a long period of time, but they were not getting a food, so they attacked into the shop. At the same time, the king ordered troops to move into Paris. On 14 July, agitated crowd stormed and destroyed Bastille. At the same time, Louis XVI ordered a troop, soldier, to march into the Paris. And in the beginning of the chapter, in the first part, I explained you as many as 7,000 women, men and women were gathered into the Paris and they attacked on the Bastille. Bastille, it was a symbol of despotic power of king. At the countryside, rumors spread from village to village that the lords of the manor had hired band of brigands who were on their way to destroy the riot crops. In countryside, in the village area, the rumors spread that the king, means the lord, had ordered a gang of robbers to destroy the crops of the peasants. Caught in a frenzy of fear, peasants in several districts seized hoes and pitchforks and attacked shutters. Now Satox is a castle, actually fort or the castle means the residence of the lord. So angry patient, when they heard the rumors, they attacked on the castle of the landlord. They looted, hoarded grain and burned down document containing record of manorial. They even attacked on the government building and they destroyed the building. They burned down all the documents related to debt of the peasants. A large number of nobles fled from their homes, many of them migrating to neighboring country. In such situation, many noble, they fled away, run away from the France, and they take shelter into neighboring country. Faced with the power of his revolting subject, Louis XVI finally accorded recognition to National Assembly and accepted the principle that his power would from now on be checked by constitution. So when situation become out of control, finally Louis XVI recognized the National Assembly and he was also agreed. Now his power would be checked by the National Assembly, means constitution. On the night of 4th August 1789, Assembly passed a decree abolishing the feudal system of obligation and taxes. So on 4th August 1789, Assembly passed a decree. Decree means formal order to abolishing feudal system and obligation system means contract system. Titles were abolished and land owned by the church were confiscated. Confiscated means taken for the public use. So they abolished the taxes, titles, tally, all the taxes, and whatever the land was owned by the church, it was confiscated. Means they declared this land, they opened this land for the public use. As a result, government acquired assets worth at least 2 billion livres. So when they confiscated the land of the church, so government got 2 billion livres by selling this land. So this way, on 14 July 1789, the French Revolution started in France and spread into countryside also. So with this, I would like to conclude my lecture. Inshallah, we will meet again very soon in the next lecture. Thank you very much.